Buying any car, including an EV, is all about balancing your wants. I want a built-in fridge, massage seats with my name embroidered on the headrest, and a 1,000-watt stereo. Against all of your needs. Safe and reliable is key. We can put the savings into our 401k. Good point, but let's save that for later, okay? Look, if you want an EV, range plays a big role in this whole messy process. You want an EV, but how much range do you actually need? We're gonna help you figure that all out. Hi, I'm Lauren from Edmunds, where we're known as the car testing pros. We've teamed up with the experts at CarMax to help you find the right car for your needs. And one thing you shouldn't need to help figuring out is how to hit that like and subscribe button to show us a little love and to continue to get the latest CarMax videos. Look, we get it. Range anxiety is real, okay? But there are two ways to overcome it. The first is just to be rich enough to afford a Lucid Air, which has more than 500 miles of range. Easy, right? That's what I'm talking about. Look at the price. Have you lost your mind? Okay, a Lucid Air is pretty far outside most people's budgets, but generally speaking, more range will cost you more. And that means you need to satisfy those wants and needs in a whole new way. The good news is that right out the gate, buying an EV satisfies a lot of your wants and needs. To figure out how much range your EV should have, you have to be realistic about how you drive and how much you drive in a day. When you buy an EV, installing a home charger is a game changer. By far, the best peace of mind measure you can take against range anxiety. It's like having your own personal gas station in your garage. Just plug in when you park for the night, and every day you'll be charged for the day. We've got a whole video on home charging. Go check it out. So let's put our needs in the driver's seat for a minute and figure out your daily mileage. According to the Department of Transportation, the average American drives about 37 miles per day. But ask yourself, how long is your commute? Is it longer or shorter than that? Anyone care to join me at the new sushi place across town after work? Don't forget we need milk from the store. I'm tired of eating dry cereal for breakfast. Right. Whatever the reason, we all have to take side trips from time to time, so be sure to factor that in too. Also, are you the kind of driver who's easy on the gas or a little bit of a lead foot? Just like a gas car, how you drive an EV will affect its range. So once you've done your homework and you know how much you drive in a day, start looking for EVs with 3 times that number. That'll give you a little cushion for those just-in-case unexpected trips. Or even just being a regular old human and forgetting to charge it one night. So let's look at a few scenarios, starting with something for those on a budget: short range. Now, if you're on an economy car budget, an EV is still within reach, especially since you won't be spending money on gas. Now, you can check out our video about how much it costs to drive 100 miles in an EV versus a regular gas-powered car for more on that. But let's say your commute is at that 40-mile national average, you only take the occasional side trip, and you don't plan on road tripping in your car. Good news, you don't have to spend a ton to get the kind of range you'll actually need. We found this used Nissan Leaf for no more than a regular economy car, and it has a range of about 150 miles. How far is that? Well, it'll get you from New York City to Scranton, Pennsylvania, or from Los Angeles to San Diego with a little room to spare for each trip. Perfect, we're all done then. Not quite. Remember that sushi place across town? And this weekend, we're going up north with some friends. So that 150-mile range isn't going to cut it. Good points. Well, let's move up to the mid-range because maybe you're driving a longer distance each day. Or maybe always you seem to be that household runner or just have an active social life. And with all that driving, you've earned the occasional weekend getaway. If you need around 250 miles of total range, it'll cost you more, but you can still drive a nicely equipped EV without breaking the bank. 250 miles is about how far the EPA estimates this used Chevy Bolt will get you. And it's more than enough for a long commute, all the errands you can think of, and even an owner forgetting to charge overnight. And 250 miles is pretty far. That's a round trip from LA to Santa Barbara or a one-way drive from New York City to Washington, D.C. You'll have more bathroom breaks than charging stops. Hey, I just remembered, Mom and Dad are retired and they're moving out to the country. Come on, let's live a little, get something fast. You two are hard to please. Look, there are even options for all of those kinds of scenarios that will keep you under the $50,000 mark, something like this used Tesla Model 3, for example. Okay, we know $50,000 is a good size sum, but it's way below that Lucid Air. And this has an EPA estimated range of 350 miles. That's far, really far, like driving from Boston all the way to Philadelphia. Or if you're from the West Coast, you can make that LA to Vegas drive with plenty of range to spare. So there you go, three different scenarios and three easy EV solutions that show range anxiety can be easily overcome with just a little bit of planning, even if you're on a budget. And even the EV with the least amount of range can be a totally useful daily driver. After all, you're going to plug it in every night and take advantage of the gas station in your garage, right? You bet. I'm setting a location reminder right now. Yeah, sure. Good. Man, you guys are stressing me out. I'm gonna go lay down. See, she said she needs to lie down. No, she just wants to. Would you two please give it a rest?